Hi, welcome to part two of the MAP tutorial, Recipe Control. In this video, we'll learn how to implement a recipe management system using MAP and VC4. To connect to a VC4 HMI application, we'll need the component MpRecipeUI. Using the MAP link input, we'll connect with the configuration object we created in part one of this tutorial, named glinkRecipe. We'll enable the component by setting the enable input. The variable UI setup contains configuration options for the HMI application. So that we have all the structures and variables we need for the HMI application, we'll set up UI connect. The data type we need for this is simply the name of the component followed by the name of the input. The next step is to add a VC4 visualization object. What's important here is to select the map technology template. This template contains ready-made pages for recipe management, as well as a simple way to link the HMI application to our control software. In the configuration, we'll enable a VNC server that we can use to access the HMI application. And we'll also set the refresh rate to 100 milliseconds. Now we have to connect the right data structure in order to link our HMI application to the control program. Under Shared Resources, we have to select Data Sources. If you refresh the list, you can see that the existing connections are now obsolete. We can use the refactor option to replace the obsolete structure with our own. All the links needed for recipe management are replaced automatically. Once we've applied our changes to the controller, we're ready to test the HMI application. We can access the HMI application using VNC Viewer. Our recipe management system is located on the page identified by the MAP recipe logo. Here we can see the recipe we created in part one of this tutorial. And if we want, we can go ahead and create a new recipe. So, in just a few easy steps, we've taken a recipe management system in software form and created a fully functional user interface for it. Thanks for watching.